Good morning, my dear students. Today I am going to tell the concept of anti-lock braking system. So as the name indicate, lock, so it will lock the say all the four wheels to stop the whole vehicle with the help of some electronic component. So it's called as anti-lock braking system. Okay, so anti-lock braking system is an electronic system which monitor and control the skidding of a vehicle during braking stage. So it's called as anti-lock braking system. Not only control the skidding, it will also allow the driver to maintain a steering control very good manner. Okay, so the main benefit of using this is even the vehicle can stop in a wet stage. Okay, now anti-lock braking system prevents the lock up and skidding even it is a slippery condition roads at any, that means at even inclined road, and it has a lower insurance cost also and higher resale the value. Traction control, so traction control nothing but it is a traction, it is a force to generate the motion between body and the inclined surfaces, that is the inclined road, that is about the traction force, and it maintain the velocity between the tire and the road surfaces. Okay, so the to study the working of this anti-lock braking system, before that we have to know the what are the components we use for the anti-lock braking system. So first component is speed sensors. So speed sensors are fixed all the four wheels. The main use for sensor is it is used to determine the acceleration of the wheel. So and these sensors uses a magnet and it will fix to near to the wheel, that is the tooth hub. Okay, and to generate a electromagnetic field, and not only this, it will generate also electrical pulsation around the wheel. So second component is wall. There is a wall in the brake line of each brake controlled by the anti-lock braking system. So depending upon the vehicle, there are three different types of walls are used. First one is the position number one wall. The wall is open and pressure from the master cylinder is passed right through the brake system. So in second position wall, that is the position number two wall, the wall block the line isolating the brake from the master cylinder, and it will prevent the pressure from the rising from coming from the master cylinder, so that further should be the driver push the brake pedal harder. Okay, the third position wall is the wall release some of the pressure from the brake system that is sent to the near to the sensor, that is near to the wheel. So these are the two component. The third component is pump. The main purpose of pump is to regulate the restore the pressure back to the brakes that has been released by the valves. Okay, the fourth part is controller. The main function of controller of anti-lock braking system is it consists of a electronic control unit, it is shortly called as ECU, which processes all the anti-lock braking system information and signal functions. So the electronic control unit gets the information from all the wheel, and then it will pass the hydraulic control unit. Okay, these are the main four parts which are using in anti-lock braking system to hold the vehicle. Okay, so how does anti-lock braking system car work? This is very very important. So it will prevent the wheel from the locking up. I told beginning also, it will lock the all the four wheels and thus avoiding the uncontrolled skidding of the vehicle and decrease the distance traveled without slipping. Okay, now that is the main work. So without an anti-lock braking system, the wheels of your car stop spinning and car will begins to skid. So if you are not using the anti-lock braking system, means if you apply a brake pedal, it will spin and it will stop some distance, little bit forward distance. Okay, so here I shown the diagram. So it consists of same the ECU unit. So it is shortly called as ECU, that is electronic control unit. Hydraulic control unit, shortly called as HCW, master cylinder. So master cylinder is very very important. On master cylinder there is a reservoir, working fluid will be stored there. Two wheel and line houses is there, wheel speed sensor and tone ring, that is also called as tone ring or tooth hub, it is rotated while doing. Okay, now at each four wheels a sensor will be fixed to get the information. Okay, when brakes are applied. So working I shown here, I explained here six steps. I will tell this working. So when the brakes are applied, fluid is forced from the master cylinder to the HCU unit, that is a hydraulic control unit inlet ports, with the help of open solenoid valves that are contained in the hydro control unit, then through the outlet of ports of the hydraulic control unit to each other, to pass the each wheel. Okay, when the brakes are pressed, a a master cylinder will actuate. From that there is a working fluid will pass through each wall. Okay, now that is the first working. Second one is the rear part of the master cylinder feeds the front brakes and vice versa. The remaining the coming from the fluid which will passes from the master cylinder, that is a scent, from the front brakes and vice versa, they will pass immediately to the front wheels from the master cylinder, that is near to the brake pedal. The third working is after the fluid is inserted into the each wheel, the wheel start up the locking. As fluid goes near to the wheel, it will lock the system with the help of some sensors. That is the when the control modulates the sense that wheel is going to lock up. When the control module senses that wheel is going to lock, when it is going to near to the wheel, it will lock up automatically with the help of some sensor, and it closes the normally, and it will open the solenoid valve for the wheel. Okay, now the anti-lock brake control module, then it looks at an anti-lock braking sensor signal from the affected wheel. Sixth one is once the affected wheel comes back up to the speed, then the control module return to the solenoid valve to their normal condition. Okay, so that is about the working of anti-lock braking system. See here I show in the diagram, when pedals are pressed, here master cylinder will be there. So if you look at this, when brakes are pedal, the master cylinder will activate, it will open. From in master cylinder there is a working fluid reservoir will be there. That reservoir working fluid will passes to the each wheel with the help of some hydraulic control unit and some valves. I told already there are different types of valve will be there in the part components. So as the working fluid is goes near to the wheel, it will lock up the wheel with the help of sensor. So as the working fluid is coming, the sensor will indicate to the wheel that it will lightening the app, that is, it will give the signal with the help of burning of light, the opening, that is switch on the light. Okay, now as the working fluid goes near to the wheel, it will lock automatically and it will stop the all the four wheels with some distance, so it will avoid some skidding component. That is the main working of this anti-lock braking system. Okay, so this is working, and some of the advantage of this anti-lock braking system I shown here listed 10. There are number of advantages will be there. So the by using this we can reduce the possibility of breaking the lock. Now normal lock braking system will be there. Apart from that normal brake, anti-lock brake systems are, it is an extra brake system to use in all the vehicle. Okay, it will provide the better chance of steering system. We can rotate, we can control the steering system very better. It will help to the driver to move, run the, to operate the steering system very smoothly. And it is not only that, it is very highly adaptable to every surfaces, and it has greatly reduced the possibility of breaking skidding. So skidding is avoided, and faster reaction in the situation because of the completely electronic and computer control. It is fully based on the electronic circuit, so you can stop easily automatically like this. And some of the advantages I listed here. Okay, next one is the disadvantage. What is the main disadvantage of this? Is it is very, if once it is get disturbed, that is get spoiled, then it is very difficult to repair, and it is very high cost of operation, and okay, now and require regular checkups and maintenance of sensor, valves and brake fluid. So regularly we have to check whether the sensors are working or not. So frequently we have to check it, and maintenance is very little difficult. Okay, require complete overhaul on a damage of few parts. So we have to take care every day whether the parts are damaged or not. Like this I have listed, these are some of the disadvantages. So what are the application of this system? So nowadays almost all the vehicles, the anti-lock braking system are used. Some of the car names are listed here. So that is Maruti Suzuki Swift, Maruti Suzuki Ridge, the Skoda Superb, Honda, Honda City, Honda Verna, and Hyundai i20. Like this, so number of cars they are using anti-lock braking system. This is about this anti-lock braking system concept. I hope you understand this, and this question is very, very important for the examination point of view. Every semester they are asking this question, explain with a neat sketch anti-lock braking system, around 8 to 10 mark question. So please be perfect this question. Okay, I hope you understand this concept, working and parts of anti-lock braking system. Okay, so if you have any clarification means please let me know. Okay, thank you very much.